Hi, my name is Gwen McMillin, and I'm a medical director of toxicology at ARUP Laboratories. I'm also an associate professor of pathology at the University of Utah. Drug abuse and misuse remains a prominent concern in our society, and that concern is heightened when dealing with pregnant women, because certainly the likelihood of physical, emotional, behavioral, and medical concerns is much greater in the infant that's been exposed to drugs during pregnancy than the infant that has not been drug exposed. Based on results from the National Survey on Drug Use and Health, which was most recently published in 2010, it's estimated that in the United States there are between 200,000 and 500,000 drug exposed infants born every year. Now, the signs and symptoms of drug exposure can be difficult to distinguish from clinical scenarios such as a metabolic disorder. So it's important that drug testing be performed to direct care appropriately. Drug testing to identify and characterize an exposure in an infant is most commonly performed with meconium. Meconium is the first stool of the newborn, and it's thought that drugs accumulate in the meconium throughout the pregnancy. Meconium is probably most useful at identifying exposures during the last trimester and can detect some drugs used during delivery. So, of course, meconium is not a perfect specimen. Some of the other disadvantages of meconium are that it may be lost in utero, particularly for an infant in distress. It also may take several days to pass, such as in a constipated infant that maybe was exposed to opioids during pregnancy. Meconium may also be unavailable for testing if a drug-using mother chooses to take the meconium. So, in any case, the time required to get a result regarding drug testing with meconium can be several days to weeks. An alternative specimen that is available for drug testing is the umbilical cord itself. So the advantages to umbilical cord testing is that, of course, every child has one, and it's available at birth. This would significantly reduce the potential time for drug testing. We and others have published several studies demonstrating that umbilical cord can be equally sensitive and specific as meconium, and I would encourage you to consult the literature for specific applications. You can also look at our website, aruplab.com, for additional information.